Small business owners know cutting costs without cutting quality is tough. How do you trim expenses without hurting your business? Easy. Get Spectrum Business. Call 888-489-2212. Switch to Spectrum Business and you can get the best internet and phone services for half of what you're paying today. Cutting costs can be easy when you get Spectrum Business. Just call 888-489-2212. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Odyssey now has hundreds of new exclusive music stations for you to discover your new summer soundtrack.
Get moving with worthy workouts for a cardio sesh fueled by today's top artists.
Hang in with your crew? Throw it back with Picnic Party for old school jams for your cookout.
Or sail away with Odyssey's new yacht rock station, Jugger Yacht.
There are hundreds of new exclusive stations to check out today.
For summer barbecues,
road trips,
or relaxing poolside.
For every move, every interest, every passion. By Odyssey.
This hour of the Greg Hill Morning Show brought to you by East Coast Metal Roofing.
What's the outlook for the remainder of this four-game set?
It's unclear, Kevin, because Major League Baseball wants to wait until they get these three pending tests of Yankee players tomorrow before they make a decision about tomorrow's game. They want full context. Aaron Boone, the Yankees manager, talked about how disappointing and frustrating it is, but at the same time, they've been through COVID protocol before. Alex Cora telling his players today, look, they have to continue to be diligent as they did in the spring to try to prevent anything happening with their group.
It's the voice of, was the voice of baseball on ESPN. Now it's probably Jeff Passan. Buster Olney, an insider who, just like us and Wiggy and Curtis and Ken, who are all here this morning, in for Greg, who's back on Monday. He has no idea. Boone has no idea. Cora has no idea. Baseball, and this is the issue, they have no idea. They had a couple positive tests, and instead of separating those players and saying we're going to play Red Sox-Yankees, marquee game, a premium game, as Chris Curtis called it, they just banged the game, and no explanation whatsoever as to why they didn't play last night, other than there's some waiting some tests, and then no one said, well, you've done this all year, put those people aside and play, and baseball is left with their pants down, no answers. The only game last night in sports, it didn't play because baseball has no idea what they're doing right now.
And I think that's the biggest issue that most people have because, you know, we're all in the assumption that if you're vaccinated or most players in professional sports are vaccinated, that there'll be no stoppage of play.
That was the point I thought of getting these guys to 85%, right? Yeah. Teams get you to relax, and then you can move forward and play even if you have issues like this. In fact, under 85%, we've had games played with guys that get COVID. They sit out for a week or two, they get placed on the COVID list, and they come back and play. In this instance, there is no answer as to why they decided not to play the game last night.
Well, and the other thing is that where is the accountability on the team, right? They can't force players to get vaccinated because of obvious CBA and health issues. But if you have too many players that are unable to play, then you forfeit. And if Aaron Judge can't play, you play without Aaron Judge. It seems so obvious and straightforward. I just don't understand the how this could be so poorly handled by baseball.
It's and the Yankees. The Yankees had a positive test last Saturday, and apparently weren't prepared for this potential result here 5 days later.
How do they have a positive test last Saturday and send their entire crew to Colorado?
Excellent question. Why did baseball allow those guys to go if they knew they had a positive test last Saturday? Right? You said baseball should have said Yankees can't go.
Well, that's a good point. But if you guys were the commissioner of baseball and yesterday you found out six Yankees were positive, one of them was at the All-Star game, five Red Sox were there, and you didn't have enough testing to show or lapse time to show that there wasn't a massive outbreak, would you have let the game go on?
Yeah.
Because then you play the game, and then a couple days later, more positives, then you're getting crushed.
Okay.
All the players, I think, Ken, are in pretty good shape on the Red Sox and Yankees. So if they get COVID, odds are they might not even know they have it.
Well, and again, not to get into the science of this, but we know being outside and playing a game outdoors is not going to transmit COVID.
But they're in a clubhouse together.
So the guys,
whoever tested positive leaves the clubhouse.
Yeah, don't know who's positive. That's the point.
I'm positive.
No, you're negative. But all the time.
But we got to that point because they sort of got caught without any plan for this. So with football, Wiggy has it in front of him.
Yeah, I have it in front of
me. If you test positive, go through the football process here because it appears they have a plan, whereas baseball doesn't.
All right, so these are the new modifications that they're going to be employing this upcoming season, right? and fully vaccinated players, no daily testing. You'll get tested every 2 weeks. If you're not vaccinated, you got to get tested every day. Fully vaccinated players don't have to wear a mask in the facilities. You can move about as freely as you want. If you're not, still got to wear a mask. Whether you're in the weight room, it's mask-free. If you want to eat and you're vaccinated, you can go in the cafeteria. It's not an issue. There's still tons of restrictions for guys that are not fully vaccinated. So the NFL is putting that in place. The only thing that we don't know from the NFL, and they had talked about this a little bit, is that guys who are not vaccinated, and if they test for COVID, there's a chance, and they were trying to get this done, that they wouldn't get paid for games that they missed.
Bingo.
So if you're vaccinated and you get COVID again, which we saw with Chris Paul in basketball, and he misses games, he still gets paid. I think the simplest thing to do in sports, it seems like as a world we're headed in that direction, is if you're not vaccinated in sports, then you can't play.
Well, that's an extreme. What if they stuck with the football plan? Look, if you're unvaccinated, again, I don't want to say for sure, but okay, it sounds like J.D. Martinez mm-hmm. is one of the Red Sox players not vaccinated. If you get COVID and miss games, you don't get paid for those games. Or
okay,
can you, I guess, finding guys is a little extreme. But,
I like that.
You don't get paid if you miss games because you decided not to get vaccinated.
Yeah,
it's fine if you don't, but just know if you're not wearing your mask and not keeping yourself safe, then it comes out of your paycheck, not ours. And if your team can't field the team, like Curtis said,
mm-hmm.
then you shouldn't be playing games. That should be a loss for the Yankees.
Right, because in the NFL, if you are vaccinated and you do test positive, you still have to kind of sit out, but it's not as long as it used to be. So there's a really good chance that if you have COVID and you're vaccinated, you won't miss any games.
I want to talk more about this. Let's give away some money real quick, Ken.
Another typical cash giveaway. Here's this hour's code word on WEEI.
This hour's code word is scale. Text scale to 72881 right now for your chance to win $1,000 in our national cash contest. Message and data rates apply. Don't text and drive. So, I mean, Ken tried to give an actual reasoning as to why and the testing and everything else. I would argue, thinking about it now, last night's cancellation was totally about optics because they didn't want guys going in the field with the idea of unvaccinated players mm-hmm. might have gotten it. This was not, they could have played last night. They didn't because of the optics. And I get the feeling nationally there is starting to be a push towards this. In L.A., we know Saturday night, Wiggy, in Saturday mm-hmm. night in L.A., they barely had an uptick in L.A. in cases. Right, they I think were 400 hospitalized in L.A. County yesterday. In the peak of COVID, there were 5,000 a day who were testing positive. 400 tested positive. They are putting masks back on inside. Team USA basketball.
Right.
Team USA Hoops is not playing tonight against Australia because they're in the COVID protocol. Mm-hmm. Bradley Beal's home, and one of their players, Grant, also is in the protocol there. And they could go there. There's a plan in place to play with these things.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like now they're not because the optics thing is starting to come back where they're like, the Delta variant, what are we going to do? Where they told us they had a plan and not sticking to the plan. Now they're going off course.
But Mutt, you remember last year, I hate even talking about this. It brings back all the 2020
memories. You're
doing it
then. You're doing it.
But
I'm not.
We had the Patriots issue where Cam had COVID. He had contact with Gilmore.
Mm-hmm.
They played the game. Gilmore went on the plane and was around 20 guys and everybody was like panicked when they got back from Kansas City. And everybody said, NFL, what a bunch of idiots. Why would they play this game? Why would you rush it? Why would you put Gilmore on that plane with 20 other people?
Okay, that was getting on a plane. These guys were all there, right? These guys were already all there in New York. The guys who test positive, you take them out. They didn't do it on a plane because they didn't know at that point with Gilmore.
But again,
they should have.
Gilmore, they didn't know Gilmore was positive until the Wednesday after. So it was like 4 or 5 days later.
But Ken, it's...
And the fog that came after it.
It's different now, though, because even with the NFL restrictions that the vaccinated players can now, they can go out with their families. When they go on the road, they can leave the hotel room. If you're not vaccinated, when you go to the hotel, you got to stay there.
And wouldn't you love to know, Wiggy, if they're adhering to that? Like, I bet you that's part of this, too.
Of course they're not.
There's no way that, like, the teams that are the 85% even, that had the lax things, like, the guys who are unvaccinated are really standing by those protocols.
You think Aaron Judge, who we know now, was reported as didn't get vaccinated, you think he was, like, hunkered down in the hotel in Colorado?
I'm sure we could find pictures online of him at different events. And that's another issue. They realize now, probably doing their back testing, shoot, we were not strict enough with these guys. But that's a baseball issue, maybe not a Red Sox or Yankees issue.
But the baseball issue should be now, if you are unvaccinated, we're not going to postpone the game. You're going to miss that game check. So, like, Aaron Judge,
I love that.
Aaron Judge and the guys who didn't play, you guys are not playing. You're not getting paid for that game. And the guys that are vaccinated, you will play. Because we know with the new we know with the vaccination kind of protocol that if you get it, they'll test you like really quickly the next day and the next day. And once you have a negative test, you can go back to play. So you don't have to miss out. Or if you get COVID and you're vaccinated, you can still get your game check. Where Judge and those other guys, they shouldn't be allowed to get paid for the games that they miss because they're not vaccinated.
I mean, if you're vaccinated, they really shouldn't test you at all. I'd be fine with that.
Well, it's
you?
Every 2 weeks in the NFL. I don't know what it is in baseball.
Well, is this... Is the idea here they everyone traveled for the All-Star break, and so every team came back and did a batch of testing? I don't know if that's the reasoning why, but I mean I'm with you. If you've gone through the vaccination process, mm-hmm. You said in football it's every 2 weeks,
right?
Maybe we can find the baseball protocols. Like I assume it's because of the All-Star break. I'm sure not testing every day with some of these guys, but I mean it's not surprising that baseball's in this spot. They argued last year before they could even get on the field. They fought back and forth, couldn't figure out their details. They couldn't figure out how to get back on the field itself. They fought about the protocol rules between the union and the league back and forth. And now you sent guys to the All-Star break, apparently didn't care whether they're vaccinated or not, and you put yourself in a position where a premium game, trademark Chris Curtis, gets banged on a Thursday night. Now, are they playing two? Ken wants to play two tonight. There's no shot they're going to play two.
There's a shot.
I don't think they're going to play tonight.
Only vaccinated players. And you call up who you need. You got time. Bring them in from Worcester, wherever. Bring them in from Philadelphia. Where's the AAA affiliate of the Yankees? Are they Reading or something?
I believe it is Columbus, Ohio.
Oh, yeah, Columbus Clippers. Yeah, bring them in from that. They'll get there. They'll get there tonight.
I would have lost a lot of money if I walked in today saying Curtis knows the AAA affiliate of the New York Yankees.
Well, Columbus is a great town.
They now have time to do it.
Yep.
So I'm saying there's no excuse not to play tonight, Ken, but I have no faith in baseball to get it right. Do you?
I've got faith.
The Red Sox AAA squad is in Worcester. They're called the Woo Sox.
Woo, they play at Polar Park, the old Vortex.
I love Polar.
So it's
delicious sparkling water.
The Crowley family.
Here you go for Major League Baseball, right?
Yep.
Is they will have the option of decreased testing to twice weekly and will not have to quarantine if they have been in close contact with someone who was diagnosed with COVID. So those are for people, guys who have been vaccinated. So it looks like they're doing twice a week.
If they had close contact?
No. For the testing, because Mutt asked.
That's a lot. Yeah, twice a week if you're vaccinated?
Even now?
Yeah, that's what
for a sport that's outside, again.
That's what Major League Baseball says here on ESPN. Where in the NFL, the NFL new protocol is that if you are vaccinated, they'll test you every 2 weeks.
Why would you test vaccinated people? I'm not yelling at you, Wiggy. I don't understand.
This is a weird spot to be in. You don't make them vaccinated, but you still test everybody.
Yeah.
Like so it's again, that seems like an optics
thing. Now baseball cares a lot about testing. The irony.
Dave in Connecticut wants to weigh in here. Dave, what's going on?
Yeah, good morning. The solution here really is stop testing these major league players. You know, the military stopped testing. You don't hear of any outbreaks any there because you know something? All these young adults that are playing baseball, all younger than me and Wiggy, who both have had it. Me and Wiggy and Greg, we're the safest people in the world out there because we've had it. We can't pass it to anybody. We can't get it again. So they got to stop testing. Let these guys, if they get it, give them some Tylenol. If they get sick, stay home. They got to stop testing.
Well, they should. And if you're going to test, then have a plan in place when guys test positive. Here's how we're going to handle it. Instead of saying, oh, can't play the only game on the schedule tonight.
Here's what I would ask.
Imagine football doing that, like they've had a week off to prepare, ready to go. I know I pushed some games back, but that was in the midst of the pandemic. Like this year, imagine the NFL getting caught like that. We'd rip them for a month.
Value is detected.
There's no way.
That was a live COVID reading on the air. Greg got his test back live on the air.
No. Ken turned even whiter.
There's no way you should have any postponements. And because I'd ask this question, right? If everybody gets vaccinated at 100%.
Never going to happen, but okay, let's play that game.
Let's play that game.
Unrealistic.
So visit vaccines.com. Vaccines.com.
Will they then
Biden said that Brady was attacked by a service dog today.
Will they then do away with testing?
Sure. Theoretically, if everyone's vaccinated, why are they testing? But they're not there.
We need a vaccination.
No. Not doing it. Nope. No.
Restaurants strong.
Jerry in a car. Hi, Jerry. Jerry.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody.
What's up, Jerry?
Wiggy, you are out of your mind. Walk with me, if you will, back to the day mm-hmm. when you were getting game checks. I have no idea what your game check was. I don't want to know. But I want to know how you would react if somebody came up to you. Now, back in that time, we had the flu and cold season. You remember that?
Yep.
Cold and flu season?
Yep.
We had four strains of the flu, A, B, C, and D. Every year, everybody got some variation of that flu, whether they were inoculated or not. They had flu shots. So what would your reaction be if the general manager came up to you back then and said, hey, you haven't gotten your flu shot. You're not going to get a check.
Well, if the flu was as dangerous...
It's the same thing. No. The flu is the same
Jerry,
thing. It's only the first time
Jerry,
through.
Jerry,
give this 3 or 4 years. No, let me finish. Give this 3 or 4 years, Wiggy, and this is going to be just another strain of the flu.
Okay. Flu is nothing to sneeze at.
Thank you, Dr. Jerry, for your medical analysis here on the Greg Hill Show.
I would say...
Dr. Jerry Punch.
I would say, and Ken probably would agree...
Scored a 10-9 in favor of Wiggy in that round.
Ken would probably agree with this, and there are a lot of people out there would say that COVID and the flu are completely different, right? So we know...
I'm not going to pretend to know, and none of the caller like he knows anything. Jesus Christ.
But just based...
Hey, look, Mike got an excuse to go back to WebMD.
Yeah, I know, right?
But just based on what the scientists
says here,
say,
some symptoms you're having...
But
itchy, red spots.
But based on what the scientists tell us, don't they say that the COVID and the flu are completely different?
I know that we saw you a few weeks ago for your paxlotaxel infusion. How did it go after that?
All right, this has gone national, by the way. So Ken's favorite guy, Scott Gottlieb, was on the Squawk Box this morning.
Squawk Box.
I love that spot.
I mean,
CNBC.
Squawk Box is
actually
basically
like
Gottlieb. Porn.
He's pretty good.
He's very good.
Does sound like a porn site.
He's realistic with this stuff.
Yeah, right.
Oh my God, I just clicked it. It is. What I don't understand is why these baseball teams didn't require everyone to be vaccinated. The individual who introduced that infection cost that team a tremendous amount. That's his take. So he mm-hmm. thinks that every baseball player should be vaccinated.
I mean, a lot of companies are going that way. You mentioned that earlier, right?
Yep.
Yeah, well, that's what I said. It almost is putting in place that forcing guys to say, hey, you better get vaccinated because if you don't, here's the list of things you can't do. But now, rather than postpone games, the guys who are not vaccinated, and every team knows who's not vaccinated, right? They know.
They're not saying, but they know, yeah.
No. They're not saying who it is, but in that organization, like the Red Sox know exactly who's not vaccinated. So those are the guys, when there's an issue, it's going to go straight to them. Like those are the guys that are screwing it up for everybody else. When you look at the Yankees-Red Sox game, Judge and these other guys that J.D. Martinez who are not vaccinated, they're the reason why the game got postponed.
Because that's the optics part of it. Because if they were vaccinated, they would just say, like, and that's why they're sort of spinning it. Like, Passan is saying, oh, majority of the players that got it are already fully vaccinated.
Right.
Well, if you weren't worried about the other guys, you would have played right through. But the optics of it, you're now worried about it and canceling games. I mean, I think it's a players union thing, right, Chris? I mean, to answer Gottlieb's theoretical rhetorical question, like, it's because they're worried about the players union and Tony Clark saying, we're not going to require our guys to get vaccinated.
Right.
That's it.
There are member players that do not want the shot.
Right.
Including on this Red Sox team.
And meanwhile, Ted Williams got a cryogenic vaccine.
And his head's on ice somewhere.
Well, I got to get that DNA and make some hitters.
I'm telling you, he'll come back.
Bob in New Hampshire. Go ahead, Bob.
Put his head on a body.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys. How are you this morning?
Hi, Bob. What do you got, pal?
I had three quick points.
Oh.
One, if we have this in baseball, this forfeit thing, how come it just isn't instituted so that maybe they'll get some attention and say, we've got to do something here. We just can't keep doing it. And second, you guys keep talking about the virus. Where I live, both Mass and New Hampshire, for several months now, whenever you go anywhere, there's a sign in the door that says, if you have been vaccinated or not, mask required. There's no checks and balances.
Right.
And
there
third, not that it matters, but third, I know a guy who's like Sal from Revere. He sells everything. This guy's been selling bootleg certificates. In other words, you get him a Mai Tai, he'll give you a certificate. He's been doing very well with his business. What's up with
Bob,
that?
I want to confirm that. I have friends of mine have bought online the fake vaccination cards.
Right.
But what do they use it for?
Yeah, what do you use it for? You don't need to show it anywhere.
There are certain places that, I'll give you one, like upstate New York in Saratoga. They require you to be vaccinated.
Oh, my God.
Vaccinated.
Degenerate.
Community.
But
that's bad. There's a lot of old people at those things.
I'm just telling
so
you.
So you have to show your card to get in.
So your degenerate friends.
There's unvaccinated. So if you're vaccinated, you can have like 90% of the park.
Right, then but there's you have a 10% to show the card, section though, to get in.
To be in the unvaccinated population of the track, yes.
Okay. So meanwhile, they shoot the horse up with anything under the sun.
Right, Bob Baffert's
Do the
back
horses
somehow.
Have COVID? I'm not sure.
Your degenerate friends are endangering the 90-year-old community that fills Saratoga.
You asked for an excuse.
No,
I'm telling you, these two
that
are not related.
That is awful.
That is bad money.
That's worse than parking in a handicap spot.
They're
I don't know who
they're
would
not,
do that.
They're not, you asked me for a place for looking for vaccination cards. I'm just telling you, in that state. And there are other sporting events that are going to start doing this, by the way.
You think?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Absolutely.
There's only like 5 horse fans left. Why are you going to kill them?
Why would they start doing it? There's already been sporting events everywhere. We've seen full basketball, full hockey, full baseball. They haven't asked for vaccine cards.
Okay, you wait. I'm predicting this. They're going to start. There'll be even some restaurants going to start doing this. When people start freaking out about what goes on in L.A. And there are fake vaccination cards being sold. That guy, Bob, is right. Bob's right about that. They're not. You could find it in a second.
Yeah,
in a second. You don't need it. You already had it.
No. But I'm wondering. But that's what I'm saying. What if somebody who's already had now you have to walk around with your COVID test where you tested positive?
They have T-shirts that said "I had COVID." You have to wear that 24/7. Curtis,
wear that to the restaurant.
Curtis, Wiggy, Mutt, Ken Laird's got trending.
OMF weekdays 2 to 6. Now here's what's trending on WEEI.
All right, trending brought to you by Red River Technology. Red River Technology decisions are not black and white, but think red. Now stay tuned during trending. I've got the new hot top 10 list, top 10 tight ends, according to ESPN, just out. So our
during
Hunter Henry,
trending or coming up?
No, during trending. Sometimes people tune out of trending.
Oh.
Just a couple people, but some people do. So stay tuned for that in just 60 seconds. But I want to play this cut from Aaron Boone. What happened last night? 6 Yankees testing positive for COVID, including Aaron Judge, the game postponed. Here's the manager of the Yankees.
Yeah, I mean, we'll just tackle it as best we can, you know, as far as, first and foremost, obviously anyone that's testing positive, making sure they're, you know, help them, you know, be as healthy as can be. You know, obviously we have a couple of them that have had symptoms, but are for the most part doing pretty well. So we'll just, you know, rally around them and give them the support they need and see where this thing goes as, you know, the hours kind of unfold and we wait to get, you know, more of the lab-based testing back.
So they're waiting for the tests. And Cashman, the general manager, said most of the 6 Yankees had been vaccinated. Most of them.
Yeah, see, that makes no sense.
And if it was all, they would have played last night.
Cora admitted not all of his 5 All-Stars have been vaccinated, as you pointed out earlier. Anyway, COVID impacting men's hoops for Team USA. Australia exhibition canceled. Bradley Beal is off the team. 1 exhibition left Monday before they leave for Tokyo.
See, that I can understand, though, because there are some, we talked about this yesterday, there are some countries that they don't have access to the vaccine, so maybe some teams might not have a lot of players that are vaccinated. So I can understand the Olympic side of it, but Major League Baseball, that I don't get.
We have a new low here. The White House just tweeted, Dr. Fauci and Olivia Rodrigo reading mean tweets.
Oh, that's a good idea. She's going to sell a lot of vaccines.
Oh, my God.
Now,
Hashtag Man Crush Monday? What is that?
Open Championship, Mutt, you were saying historic possibility earlier, but Morikawa bogeyed one hole, apparently. So you finished 9 under for the tournament, 6 under today. With
all right, who cares about that? Get to your top 10 tight ends.
That's big.
No, it isn't.
Colin Morikawa, 3-shot lead at the Open.
Aren't there 2 more days left?
Yeah.
Yeah, the tournament's not over. So he's going to make the weekend.
Moving day tomorrow.
Top 10
tight ends. Yeah, Saturday is moving day. Tomorrow morning.
All right, here's your top 10 list. Who do you think's number one?
Number
one tight end in football per 50 execs.
Either George Kittle or Travis Kelce.
Travis Kelce, come on, what are we doing?
Nope, it's Kittle. Second year in a row. Kittle 1, Kelce 2.
Good job, Wiggs.
Darren Waller 3rd.
Yep.
Raiders tight end. Mark Andrews of the Ravens 4th.
Down year, but he's good, yep.
Jonnu Smith and Hunter Henry should both be in the top 10.
Hold on, let's see, that's 4.
5th, Detroit's TJ Hawkinson.
Iowa kid, where's Evan Ingram here?
6th, Dallas Goedert, Philadelphia Eagles.
Yep.
7th, we finally get the Hunter Henry.
Okay.
One exec says he's young, more dynamic version of Kyle Rudolph. So that's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
It's a good comp.
Is what he is, says one other AFC exec. Not great all around, but will wow you in the passing game with great hands.
Okay. Cam Brate, O.J. Howard, and Gronk on there anywhere?
Going to need those hands with Cam.
Then Evan Ingram of the Giants, 8th, and Jonnu Smith is 9th.
Mm-hmm.
Jonnu Smith, 9th. So you got 2 top 10 tight ends per ESPN.
Bucks
on your
getting
Patriots.
Disrespected left and right.
There you
was
go.
Gronk 10?
Gronk was 10?
10, nope, was Zach Ertz.
Wow, Gronk Zach Ertz over Gronk?
Eagles have two top ten
Zach titles. Ertz is
no
stinks.
Way. Yeah, Gronk.
He's washed.
Yeah, I would take Gronk over Zach Ertz
in a second.
Wow. With bad quarterback play last year. Maybe this might be the
Evan
year.
Ingram too. Wow, that's
Evan Ingram. The Evan Ingram's have two
he's,
guys. In
he's
there.
Good.
That's
he's
high
good.
Though, but he's somebody that he hasn't put
athletic
up the numbers.
Freak.
Yeah, he just needs to wait for
Daniel
that.
Jones.
Oh, we'll see.
That's your trending on the Greg Hill Morning Show.
Small business owners know cutting costs without cutting quality is tough. How do you trim expenses without hurting your business? Easy. Get Spectrum Business. Call 888-489-2212. Switch to Spectrum Business and you can get the best internet and phone services for half of what you're paying today. Cutting costs can be easy when you get Spectrum Business. Just call 888-489-2212. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Ready to go. We're back to more The Greg Hill Show on EEI.
The more I think about New England, the more I hear about the Mac Jones love affair. I don't know what they are. They also, historically, Belichick starts slow in September, and they've got 9 new free agents. This could be really choppy for New England in September. I think Miami will come out with a bang. Tua will be energized. I'll take the Patriots third at 9-8.
Whoa, July 15th, the Cowherds winning and losing it. Mike Francesa style. This is the Greg Hill Show. Greg back on Monday. Courtney Cox and Wiggy and Curtis and Ken. As the Yankees said, a majority of their players vaccinated. Majority of the show is here today. Curtis, Ken, Wiggy are here. And I don't think that's a crazy prediction from Colin Cowherd. I understand that people are very excited about this team. But there are legit questions from the quarterback to what they're going to do with Gilmore to the actual offensive skill guys. It sounds like a negative take from Cowherd, but I think 9-8 is a very realistic prediction for this team this
you
year.
You might be right, Mike, but let me just question that for a second.
Yeah.
Are people really excited about this team?
Are they?
That's my question.
Yes.
They're excited about the possibility.
Patriots fans are really excited?
I think they are because all the offseason acquisitions you just talked about, you have two tight ends in the top 10 at that whatever poll that was. So
ESPN did an executive ranking of the top 10. They talked to different executives in football.
Right.
Yeah, but for years you had the best tight end.
Yeah, but and you were a very good football team. So you have two of the top 10. You have two talented receivers. Your offensive line is really
right,
solid.
The most important position. I know how you feel about them. Again, right? I'm asking you, but I would say the majority of Patriots fans are very dubious when it comes to their starting quarterback.
I would agree with that, but I would say to them, listen, you're going to see something different because of the talent that you'd have.
Would I be curious, and maybe it's not good for a poll question, but are people more excited about the Patriots in general or the idea of Mac being the next guy? Like that, to me, that's where part of the excitement is, or I'd say majority of it, is hoping that Mac's the quarterback and what this offense would look like with an actual vertical quarterback threat versus Cam, who's an on-the-ground threat.
I think it's more of the team because of all the additions that you got.
I think it's Mac.
Prior
first
to the draft.
First-round pick, QB?
Yeah, but look how much money you spent prior to the draft. The record-setting offseason for Belichick spending all that money. I mean, you got...
Well, that just said more about his drafting than it did about this year's team. I mean, he had a lot of holes that he had to fill in for
right,
agency.
And right. About his fear of being falling into relevancy trying to fight for John
right,
Shula.
And just to finish the Cowherd prediction, yep. So you know his whole AFC East, he had Bills 12-4 winning the division.
12-5, you mean?
Up 12-5, sorry. Mm-hmm. 10-7 for the second place Dolphins and 9-8 for the Patriots.
Okay.
The Dolphins could definitely win a game more. I mean, 2 is the big key there. But I mean, the excitement level, I think, is tied into Mac. I don't think many people, unlike Wiggy, I think people are excited to watch Cam go back in their quarterback. There
and
are
I
some...
want me some of that Mac sauce in my dinner.
Yeah, but I think
there are some Cam fans that want to go watch him play. Most of us, I think, are waiting for him to struggle and Mac Jones to get the opportunity.
Do you think people are more excited because of what Bill did in the offseason or what he did in the draft?
I think it's Mac Jones is a bigger deal than every combination of guys they signed. The tight ends, the receivers, everything else. If you said you could have one or the other, they take the future quarterback. Oh, they hope, knock on wood, it's the future quarterback.
No, not who they would take, but the additions of all the defensive players and the offensive players, those additions, in my opinion, were –
A lot of Matthew Judon fan clubs popping up. People are Mac fans. That's what they want. Mac is quarterback.
Kraft is much more excited for the quarterback than he is for all that money he spent.
He should be.
It's the quarterback that they drafted because they see him more as the future. But looking at it this year, they feel like this team, there are people out there that are talking about if Gilmore comes back, you're talking about a top three defense that you should be able to have.
Okay, Fitzy's saying that, but other people have questions about it. Like,
who has questions about their defense?
Well, they don't have. I still would.
They were so bad last year, Wiggy. They couldn't stop a nosebleed.
And they answered a lot of questions with the offseason acquisitions.
That's fine. But for years, for 20 years, I'm not saying you, Wiggy, but Patriot fans mock the hell out of teams who spend a bunch of money in free agency. They used to say, oh, those teams, you can't win the thing in March. They're spending money now because their team's not any good. So now the Patriots didn't know those guys are going to hit? Come on.
Patriots players were like, why are they not spending money to get guys with
fans?
Fans. That's what I'm saying. No. Fans were like, why are they not spending money?
Oh, the Jets spent money. They're idiots. No. They're laughing stock.
Patriots fans were like, why are the Patriots not spending money to get guys to play with Brady? We heard that all the time. You hear people criticizing Belichick and not going out there and spending money to get those type of players. And when he did make moves where he brought in Gilmore and made him the highest paid defensive back at the time, there was excitement there. Finally, he's willing to open up his checkbook.
Well, I'm going
to
jump in and let people know this poll question is an interesting one. This will sort of this answers the question, Curtis, without asking Mac Jones' question. Curtis asked on Twitter at the Greg Hill Show, will the Patriots team make the playoffs with Cam Newton starting all 17 games? And that sort of would tie mm-hmm. into the excitement for the team versus, say, Mac Jones, right?
Because if you don't think they're a playoff team, you aren't excited.
That's a fair point.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So you have a list of tight ends there. The Patriots have two of the top tight ends in football, according to ESPN's executives. How about the wide receiver list there? Because there are some names on that list that Bill could have gotten. Instead, he signed Aguilar and Kendrick Bourne.
Correct.
Yeah,
they have nobody in the top 10. Obviously.
No. Devontae Adams 1.
Couldn't have gotten him. That's fine.
DeAndre Hopkins 2. Wiggy claims they could have gotten him.
Really?
Why couldn't you have? He went for a second round draft pick. You had a relationship with Billy O'Brien who traded. You're not saying you didn't have a chance to get DeAndre.
He's better than Devontae Adams. Look at the quarterbacks he's played with.
Hey, Devontae Adams
with.
Pretty good.
Okay, he's also with Aaron Rodgers.
Deshaun Watson's pretty good.
We just got a text from a guy outraged at Brian Barrett. I don't know what the hell he's doing listening right now.
Let's have him call in. I'll talk to the Barrett callers. I mean, most in-shape guy in the building. Guy's an Adonis.
He is a Brian workhorse. Barrett. He has not taken a day off in like months. He works every day for us
good
doing
for
something.
Him.
He's awesome.
Anyway, 3 is Stephon Diggs. They definitely could have got him.
Yep, they could have got him.
Huge miss by Bill.
Pretty good.
4th is Tyreek Hill. 5th is Julio Jones.
Could have gotten him. Didn't want him.
So you could have gotten 3 of the top 5 wide receivers. You had the chance.
And you signed Aguilar and Kendrick Bourne.
Yeah.
Keep going.
And then make matters worse, if you jump down to 9 and 10, it's DK Metcalf and A.J. Brown, who you could have drafted
took Nikhil Harry.
That is unbelievable.
And the poll question, early results, only 40 votes in the last 20 seconds or so, but 76% say they will not make the playoffs with Cam Newton as the starting quarterback.
6th easiest schedule in the NFL.
And by the way, 30% don't think I'm a Brady hater, so take that, Curtis, from an earlier poll question.
Seven.
You voted 16 times.
But 70 do. I mean,
this team's a playoff team.
They're a borderline playoff team, especially if they don't. The Gilmore thing, and you guys talked about it, you might not have been here Monday when they talked about it, because these guys, Ken and Curtis, had Jeremy Fowler on from ESPN on the weekend, and Jeremy Fowler speculated that Julio Jones in the trade, no, I'm sorry, Stephon Gilmore in the trade market, the Patriots traded him. We were at the second or third round pick.
Okay.
And it led to a discussion on this show, I think it was Tangway and Bradford and Mego, about potentially trading Gilmore. That'd be one of the worst moves Bill Belichick, and maybe the worst move Belichick's ever done, to decide we don't want to pay Steph Gilmore, we're not paying our quarterback anything, we'll trade him for a second and third round pick because he wants to get money. And if you trade him or he holds out, then how are your top three defense?
But I think this would be a good sign if Bill traded Gilmore, because Bill never paid the Gilmores of the world. Third contract, coming off an injury, not the greatest year the year before. I think if Bill pays him like he did last year and just sort of cowers to the pressure, I think the Patriots fans should be frustrated with that, because this organization is where it is in part because of Bill's disciplined approach to contracts.
But what has been the backbone? Brady. I don't have to tell you that. You've said that for a year on this show. So Brady is gone now. you have to pay other positions. You used to be able to sort of shrug off and say, well, Brady can fix that for us. You should, he's the best defensive player.
But you're still a top five defense without him, I believe.
No shot. Yeah, we can't debate. I mean, we don't know, but I don't.
But how many times has a Belichick defense lost a stud secondary member and, like, Earthwin Moreland comes in or some obscure guy off the bench that we didn't really think much of? And they play great. If their front seven is as good as it is,
right,
I don't think they need Gilmore.
They went from Revis to Butler to Gilmore. They've had a number one corner essentially for... Okay, thank you. He's not number one corner.
He's top 10 on an ESPN list.
He is?
Yes, he's 10th.
Where's Gilmore?
He's high.
They delivering it?
You can't pull
he
out.
Is,
look at it. Is he one or two?
Gilmore's got to be
Ramsey's
three.
Probably one. Oh, they have every position today? I like this.
Gilmore's probably top
five. He's fourth.
Five.
He's fourth.
All right.
No appreciation. So for you the have delivery
you have two good, you have two go. Two of the top
good
10
call
corners.
Back to the news. Good job.
You have two of the top 10 corners. So if you lose Gilmore, you're probably still a top five. With Gilmore, you're a top three.
See, I
why if J.C. Jackson's considered a one, and then Curtis is right, they usually find a guy. We don't know what Jonathan Jones is. We don't know what.
We know what Jonathan Jones. He's been in the league forever.
Jaywan Williams could be. So you don't know. Maybe you factor in. And then with the front seven, that's been their biggest issue. The front seven has been their biggest problem. And then with all the additions that they made up there, if you got a really good front, look at, and Curtis is, you know, Curtis might like this, he might not like this. Look at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, what you're able to do with a front seven and a young back end. It wasn't like Tampa doesn't have studs on the back end. They got young guys.
But they had studs like White in the middle.
Tampa has a pretty good back. Antoine Winfield?
But he's a young guy. I bet you Tampa doesn't have a top 10 safety or corner.
I disagree.
On that list. I bet you they don't.
Okay. No, Winfield. Right. Winfield's top 10.
Is he top 10?
I think so.
I'm not sure.
They had Lamonte David. They had Devin White.
Yeah, talking about the secondary.
I'm talking about the secondary. Their front seven is legit. In the back end, they have a lot of young players. I don't know if Antoine Winfield Jr. is a top 10 right now, but he will be one day. The kid Whitehead, I don't think he's top 10. I don't think they have a top 10 safety or defensive back. But their front seven, if you have a front seven, that's what gives offenses problems. That's why Patrick Mahomes couldn't do anything.
All right, I'm at the cornerbacks. Let's see. Number one is Jalen Ramsey. Two, Marlon Humphrey. Three, Xavien Howard. Gilmore number four. Tre'Davious White, five. Jair Alexander, six. Lattimore, seven. Denzel Ward, eight. Slay. J.C. Jackson is 10. Two Patriots in the top 10.
Right.
Not a single buck.
Not a buck. And I bet you it's the same thing for safeties. So if your front seven is legit or is really good, look at, i.e., the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, you can have, you know, still a young back end, or you have a J.C. Jackson who's up in the top 10. If you don't have Gilmore no more, you could still easily.
They're a playoff team without. If they traded Gilmore tomorrow, they're a playoff team.
Yeah. You're right. No safeties shot. Either.
No safety either. Yeah. It's all about the front seven, man. And Curtis was right. Yeah, they'll find another guy to throw in there, especially if their front seven is legit.
In this division now, they're going up against Josh Allen in that offense and Steph Diggs. Tua, they reloaded with Will Fuller and the kid from Alabama.
But we don't know what Tua is yet.
Okay, well, there are stud receivers on that team.
Right, but
they brought in Will Fuller, and they drafted Jalen Waddle. And they had Gesicki. Right. He was basically a wide receiver on a tight end's body.
Right.
Already a great receiving core. We know what's going on in Buffalo with Cole Beasley, the anti-vax guy, and Steph Diggs.
Yep. Their first three games, they're playing the Dolphins at home. I don't think Tua is very good. Then they have the Jets next week, enough said. And then they have the Saints with Jameis Winston. Not exactly murderer's row of quarterbacks.
Right. Right. They're tough.
What's that week four game again?
Yeah, well,
I think it's a bye.
going into week four, even if Cam Newton's the starter, you have enough talent on paper and the teams that you're playing, you should be 3-0.
The Patriots schedule, man, they should be good this year. All right. I mean,
They should be a playoff team.
If they have a good quarterback, they would be.
Well, right now, the people are saying they're not. You can vote right now. We'll keep an eye on this at the Greg Hill Show's Twitter account. Will the Patriots team make the playoffs with Cam starting all 17 games? We'll keep track on that. We'll have reaction nationally. People continue to take a page from their main Wiggins book. They want to defend Cam Newton at all costs. And we can go to the movies in the 9 o'clock hour. This is the Greg Hill Show.
The Greg Hill Show on EEI.
All right, Unprovoked during the break. It's the Greg Hill Show. Greg back on a Monday. Courtney Cox here. It's the embark on a new version of the Greg Hill Show with Curtis and Ken and Wiggy, of course. You're scrolling the internet and you
sizzling hot.
Something crawled in that head of yours that you're dying to spit here on a Friday morning on the show.
Yes, this is
a lot of room.
This is it's all right. A lot of room means you can store a lot of stuff up.
Is it a food take or a sports take?
No, this is a sports take, kind of off of what we were talking about. And Colin Cowherd who said something about.
He says the Patriots are third in the division at 9-8.
Here's what I'm going to tell you, that the AFC East is a two-horse race. Patriots and Bills. And the East is going to be determined by those games. The Miami Dolphins will start off the season 0-5.
Does Flores get fired?
Patriots, Bills, at the Raiders, Colts, at the Bucks.
Okay. 0-5.
They will not even be in the race of the AFC East. It's a two-horse race, and it is your New England Patriots and the Buffalo Bills.
Welcome to Miami.
And that division will be determined by those two games that they play each other.
Mark it down. Okay. I have a little more faith in the Dolphins than you do.
You don't think a 0-5 Miami Dolphins start is not a hot take?
I don't think people think they're that good. What's their over-under at Vegas, Mutt?
I think it's 8.5.
Is it really?
Holy cow. Speaking of not a lot of room, your entire head is over-unders and Saratoga.
I can check it. I mean, I could be wrong. I haven't looked in a while.
Did your horse win the fifth yesterday, by the way?
Ran second. To a horse, by the way, in a 92 buyer in his debut camp. Ran into a monster.
Oh. All right. Vegas Insider has the Miami Dolphins at, Jesus Mary, 9.
9 wins. So they can't. Come on.
I was close.
You don't think.
I don't talking about.
0-5 Dolphin start is not a sizzling.
They play 17 games this year.
Yeah.
The Jets are -1. How is that?
They'll be underdogs in all 5 of those games, won't they?
That's why they'll be 0-5.
Yeah.
They'll be 0-5. So
it's expected.
Is the opener at Gillette or is it in Miami? My bad.
It's at Gillette.
They will be underdogs.
Bills at home.
Bills at home at the Raiders.
Underdogs. They will not be underdogs at the Raiders.
Yes, they will.
Yes, they will. They'll be, then they got the Colts at home and then at the Bucks. They'll be 0-5.
There's a potential for like a 1-4 start there, 0-5 start.
That's what I'm saying. And then if you, and vice versa, when you look at the Patriots schedule and the Buffalo Bills schedule, Patriots could end up 4-1, and so couldn't the Bills could possibly either, Bills probably end up 4-1 when I look at their schedule. Yeah, or they could. The Bills can either maybe even go 5-0, 1-2-3-4-5. I don't know. I think they lose to the Chiefs.
Yeah, it's a little early for me to do the schedule thing, but I understand what you're saying. So basically, they fall behind and they'll never be in the race.
No, they'll never be, because if you're talking about two teams that are sitting at the top of the division at 4-1 and you're 0-5 or at best 1-4, you ain't catching it.
Well, they've committed to Tua, so that'd be a huge, I mean, wins and losses would be bad, but for their future and sort of their franchise. That would be brutal because they feel like they have the quarterback right now. And it feels like the whole AFC East, if you consider Mac Jones the Patriots quarterback, between Mac and Tua and Zach Wilson and the Jets and the Bill, like this is a legit quarterback division now. That would knock Miami down a huge peg if they fell out 0-5. And they start questioning if Tua was the guy.
And Mutt, I'm like the betting expert on the show. I'm 4-4 in predictions. Can
you
vouch for me? Yes. Mm-hmm. Bet the house, Eagles under 7 wins. That seems insane. They are getting nowhere near.
Two top 10 tight ends. We just rattled off their
tight
ends.
Their head coach is dumber than anybody in this building.
That seems impossible.
Have you heard that Sirianni guy?
Yeah, he's pretty bad.
Is he worse than Dan Campbell? Dan Campbell's not in the building. Yeah, he's not a good coach. It's a bad first press conference. Yeah, but he got some talent at quarterback.
Under.
Okay, well, Curtis making picks now. Everyone's a tout now.
And with Mac Jones, I still think you end up going 4-1 in the season.
Okay.
Start the season.
And real quick, just looking at the Bills schedule, they should be 4-0, right?
Right, until the Chiefs game.
Right. So you have 0-4 Miami, 4-0 Buffalo.
And 3-1 New England.
The Chiefs, outside of the Patriots and Bill Belichick and Brady, no team succeeds after losing the Super Bowl. Look at the history. It is awful, teams that lose the Super Bowl next year.
They don't make the playoffs the majority of years. You're right.
Yeah, that is true.
So you had some top 10 lists there, Ken. Is there a quarterbacks list there? Do they have the actual quarterback? They release these all today?
What?
No, they were one at a time. This is the same list.
Today was tight end.
Today was tight end.
Gotcha.
Yeah, the quarterback list has been out.
Honestly, an updated list to see where they. I know you had, where you had Cam, obviously.
Yeah, that was my list.
I was curious if they
Me
updated
and some
Cam
guy from Odyssey.
Because the.
Cam was second on this list.
Well, that I believe. Yeah. On Wiggy's list. Well, based on yesterday, we should play some of this when we come back. Based on yesterday, I wouldn't be surprised if Cam was on the top 10 list. ESPN, the national guys, Kellerman and Stephen A. Smith, and really everybody, are taking this page from the Jermaine Wiggins book and are going out of their way to defend
Cam
Newton.
Set the dialogue of the city.
You have set the dialogue, not for the city, nationally, for a nation.
I'm watching. I do that too.
But why can't you do what Bart Scott's doing up there on First Take right now? You should be making real money on ESPN because they're stealing your takes on a national level.
I can set the dialogue for the city.
I want to hear these guys. You guys want to hear these guys defending
Cam
Newton.
I feel like I need a mint after I hear this.
We'll see if you guys agree with the ESPN insiders on Cam Newton. And Wiggy goes to the movies in the 9 o'clock hour. You ready?
Oh, man.
Are you prepared?
Come on, man.
When I hear you, when the Dork podcast talk gets going, you kind of jump in as like a movie expert.
I am a movie expert. Movie aficionado.
We'll find out at 9:30 here next hour of the Greg
Hill
Show.
That's Italian for movie expert.
Thank you.
Small business owners know cutting costs without cutting quality is tough. How do you trim expenses without hurting your business? Easy. Get Spectrum Business. Call 888-489-2212. Switch to Spectrum Business and you can get the best internet and phone services for half of what you're paying today. Cutting costs can be easy when you get Spectrum Business. Just call 888-489-2212. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Odyssey now has hundreds of new exclusive music stations for you to discover your new summer soundtrack.
Get moving with worthy workouts for a cardio sesh fueled by today's top artists.
Hang in with your crew? Throw it back with Picnic Party for old school jams for your cookout.
Or sail away with Odyssey's new yacht rock station, Jugger Yacht.
There are hundreds of new exclusive stations to check out today.
For summer barbecues,
road trips,
or relaxing poolside.
For every move, every interest, every passion. By Odyssey. Brought to you in part by Macy's and Geico.